Now let us start our B exercise, that is potential difference and resistance. Before we start it, you should know some things, important points. If a conductor is having negative charge, it means it has more electrons because electrons carry negative charge. Positive charge, if it is carrying, it means it has less number of electrons. If it is neutral, means equal number of negative and positive charge, that is equal number of, you can call, electrons and protons. Now suppose two charged conductors, like it can be one is positive, one is negative, or it can be one positive, one neutral, one negative or one neutral. When the two charged conductors are joined by a metallic wire, free electrons flow from the conductor having higher or the more concentration of electrons to the conductor having lower concentration of electrons. Means the movement of electrons will start from that conductor which has more concentration of electrons. More electrons means more negative charge. Electrons will start flowing from that end to the end having lesser number of electrons. But remember, this movement will stop once the concentration of electrons become equal in both sides. Means after, suppose electrons have started moving from A to B. After they have started moving from A to B, one point will come when the number of electrons in both A and B will become same. That is, the negative charge will become same in both. Then the movement of electrons will stop there itself. Now let us study. First, in first case, A is positively charged, B is uncharged. Positively charged means less electrons. Uncharged means equal number, means they are not less, they are equal here. So if I am talking about the electrons or electronic current, it is always from negative to positive, we have already know. So which is more negative now? B is more negative because it is neutral, that is it has equal number of electrons and protons, means they are not less. Here it is positive, means electrons are less. So electronic current will be from B to A. And conventional current, we know that it is from positive to negative, that is from A to B. Or you can call it opposite to electronic current, that is from A to B. Now A is negative, B is uncharged. Negative means more electrons. Uncharged means equal. So electronic current will be from more to less, that is from A to B. And conventional current is opposite, that is from positive to negative, that is from B to A. Next is, one is negative, one is positive. Negative means more electrons. Positive means less electrons. That is from A to B, electronic current. And conventional current from positive to negative, that is B to A. So this has been clear to everyone. Then now we are talking about the topic potential. But remember, as we know that water also flows from high potential to low potential. Temperature or heat also flows from a body carrying high temperature to a body at low temperature. Same way, this electrons also move from high potential to low potential. Okay, now remember, whenever a body is carrying more positive charge, means it is at high potential. It is at high potential, that is it has deficit of electrons, that is electrons are less here. And negative charge means it is at low potential, that is excess of electrons, electrons zyada hai isme. And you know that current always flows from high potential to low potential, that is from positive to negative. इसीलिए जब भी हम करंट की बात करते हैं तो इसका मतलब हम किसकी बात कर रहे हैं, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट कन्वेंशनल करंट ओनली, बिकॉज करंट ऑलवेज फ्लोज फ्रॉम हाई पोटेंशियल टू लो पोटेंशियल, दैट इज फ्रॉम पॉजिटिव टू नेगेटिव, एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक करंट फ्लोज फ्रॉम लो पोटेंशियल टू हाई पोटेंशियल. नेक्स्ट इज, नो वॉट इज पोटेंशियल बेटा. सपोज वी नो दैट टू चार्जेस आर देयर. Now two charges will either have the force of attraction between them or they will have the force of repulsion between them. Now, but if these two charges are lying very far from each other, say at infinity, then we know that there will be no force. But if I have to bring the charge from infinity to that point or the near charge, what I need to do? I have to act either with the force of attraction or against the force of attraction. So I have to do some work. So that amount of work done in bringing that charge from infinity to that point is called your potential. It is again your scalar quantity. It is denoted by V is equals to W dash by Q, and the SI unit is volt. And now one is potential difference. It's important. Now what is potential difference? It is the amount of work done in transferring a unit positive charge from one conductor to another through a metallic wire. Now suppose if I have to transfer a unit positive, one positive charge from A to B through this wire, how much work I will do, that is my potential difference. that is equal to a potential difference. That is work done per unit positive charge in transferring it from one conductor to another through this metallic wire. Now it is denoted by V1 minus V2 is equals to W by Q. It is again a scalar quantity and its SI unit is also volt. Now see, potential difference SI unit is volt. Work SI unit of work is joule. For charge Q is coulomb. If I have to find the value of 1 volt, then means 1 joule by 1 coulomb, I will do it. So potential difference is said to be 1 volt if 1 joule work is done in transferring 1 coulomb charge from one conductor to another conductor through a metallic wire. I guess it is very clear to everyone.